I'm happy to join with you today. In vaudeville, it's go down in the history as the greatest demonstration for freedom in the history of our nation. 5 score years ago, a great American in whose embolic shadow we stand today signed the Emancipation Proclamation. 100 years later, the Negro is still not free. 100 years later, the Negro lives on a lonely island of poverty. I have a dream that one day our nation will rise up, live out the true meanings of its creed. We hold these truths to be our self-evident, that all men are created equal. I have a dream that one day the red hills of George and the sons of former slave and the sons of former slave owners will be able to sit down together at the table of brotherhood. I have a dream that one day even the state of Mississippi and the state of sweltering with the heat of injustice and sweltering with the heat of oppression will be transformed into a oasis of freedom and justice. I have a dream. My 4 little children live in a nation where they will not judge it by the color of their skins, but the content of their character. I have a dream today. This is our hope and is the faith that I go back to South with. With this faith, we will be able to transform the jungle and the skirts of our nation into the beautiful symphony of brotherhood. With this faith, we will be able to work together, pray together, struggle together, go to jail together, and stand up for freedom together, knowing that we will be free one day, and this will be the day. This will be the day when all of God's children were able to sing with a new meaning. This must become true. Let freedom ring in the 42 mountains of New York. Let freedom ring in the every hills and small hills of Mississippi, in every mountainside. Let freedom ring in the every state and every city and every villages. We will be able to speed up that day. Black men and white men join hands and sing in the words of old Negro spiritual. Free at last, free at last. Thank God Almighty, free at last.